In this section, we'll let you know how to collect the fees from the students. You need to go to accounts, click on collect fees. You need to select the student for which you want to collect the fees. Let's say I select Vaibhav Jindal as the person from whom I want to collect the fees. Now Vaibhav Jindal has already paid the registration amount of 100 rupees on 10th of August by cash. The complete detail has been shown out here. Installment amount, last installment amount pending, total amount to be paid, amount paid, and paid payment status. Now let's consider we are taking a fees for 10th September, which is 5450. Now what you'll see downstairs was total amount of fees was 11,000 rupees. Amount which has been paid till date is 100 rupees. Total amount pending as of today is 0 rupees because today is 11th of August and the next installment is due on 10th of September. So that's the reason it is not showing as a pending amount. The amount which was supposed to be paid by the student has already been paid on 10th of August. So total amount to be received in future is 1090, which is 11,000 minus 100 rupees is 1090. Now if I click on make payment, I'll see the selected amount which I've selected is 5450. The previous due is 0. Amount to be paid is 5450. Let's consider I'm paying only 100 rupees. So what it shows, the remaining amount is 5350. That's okay. I click on cash. I can make the payment through check. Online payment is right now not been enabled, so you can do away with that. So let's consider human has taken the payment. Now I click on pay. A receipt will be generated, which will be mailed to that Vaibhav Jindal on his email ID also. And if you have a printout, a printer, you can take a printout there and there itself. So I press cancel. Now I go back and check the status of the same again. So what's been showing out here, if you can see that I have made a payment on 11th of August for 100 rupees and amount to be paid was 5450. Now if you see in the next installment, which is on 10th of October, 5450 is the installment amount, and an installment amount pending, last installment amount pending is 5350, which was 5450 minus 100 rupees. So total amount to be paid is 10800. Now since this is the last installment, the payment has to be done in full. So if I select this and click on make payment, and if I try to make a payment of 100 rupees cash, so it will tell me remaining amounts must be less than the last check installment. So since this is the last installment, you have to pay the completed amount in full. So if I click on pay now, the complete payment has been taken and receipt been generated. So you can see the details out here that complete payment has been taken. So system make sure that you take the correct payments.